honestly, I never had a plan to become a film producer or a film writer. One thing that I wanted to do was that, yes, I wanted to make a film. And back then I thought I might just do it myself. Later, when I and Nabeel kind of cracked the idea for Namaloom Afraad, I thought it'll be a good bet if Nabeel directs it, because I had seen Nabeel's work. He had done two films for BNN, which I really liked, and I thought, he has the potential, why not, he should direct it. So we sat down together, we wrote the script, and then Nabeel ended up making it, and that's how we came in the game. See, it's beautiful to be in Pakistan in any way, but when it comes to being in films, the only challenge that we face over here is that you reach the ceiling so quick that sometimes it's like, what next? So after doing four films and mashallah, all of them, getting quite an appreciation from the country and from abroad, I now definitely do feel that there's something more that we need to tap, there's something more that we need to look for and reach out to. And that definitely is global market that we should be aiming for. Honestly speaking, I always have been, I don't know how people think of it and what they kind of, get out of my conversations when I say that, being a woman is the easiest thing and the most blessed thing that one can be. Because I always feel that, the miracles that God's given to women are maybe more than to any other, being for that matter. And that I feel also brings a lot of value addition to your work, be it creatively, aesthetically, or to have understanding of more things, like, for instance, a woman who's a mother, or a sister, or a professional worker, or a colleague, has more observations, and I think has more experience of emotions than men. I think men are generally, because the conditioning is such, considered stronger, and under that strength goes so much that they want to experience, but unfortunately, the society does not allow them to experience, which women get to, be it pain or happiness. I think we have the variation at another level altogether. So I think being a woman can only make things easy and encourage you to do more than stopping you from anything. So we have been, this partnership has been there for long now. When we started our first film, we did not know that we were going to make more films after that. We've been lucky, and God's been really kind that the film kind of clicked and everyone liked it. And then we thought, why not make another one? And the other one, the next one also, was appreciated a lot. And in the meanwhile, we figured out that yes, it is this process entirely that keeps us going, that's maintaining the friendship as well as work, and we do miss not doing work. When we're not working, we miss what we're not doing, and that is of course making films. So there's been 2 years in between these 6 years when we've not produced a film. One after Namaloom Afraad 1, and in between Actor in Law, there was a year's gap. And then 1 year's gap last year after Load Wedding. And both the times I felt that, the only thing that brings me down is not working. And it is the same impact on Nabeel. So yes, work keeps us sane and happy, and that's the thing that's keeping us going. With the film, there's a lot of other factors that play, which probably the layman or the normal audience does not understand, and it's not their job to also understand what goes behind a film when it comes to screens. So there's so many factors. I'm sure people from the industry, from media, from you all can understand what all goes into after making the film. So making a film is altogether a different job, and then releasing a film is altogether a different job. Fortunately or unfortunately, in Pakistan the market is quite free. It's open and anybody can come in any time with a film and say, okay, fine, you know, without giving a date, I can come in and release a film tomorrow, despite having somebody who's announced a date maybe a year back. So this works for some people sometimes and doesn't work for some. Unfortunately, that same thing happened to Load Wedding. There were more films and the designated films were there, but then other films came in, and more of the distribution issues were around. So it couldn't pick up as much a number of shows as it should have, and that impacted the box office. But nonetheless, the film delivered what we wanted from it, you know. It was Load Wedding, and Load Wedding was praised like anything. I couldn't believe, you know, because the film was not dubbed in Chinese, it was only subtitled in Chinese, and when people sitting around us were reacting over the lines, you know, and we could hear them laugh or sob, for a moment I was like, how can they even get, you know, so emotional about this film, which is way different than their culture. But then again, you say that's the power of film. Fahad has done all these characters for our films, where we are showing somebody from around us, you know. It's nobody who's coming from a palace, or, you know, he's not a Prince Charming. He is a person who can be a guy next door, but can be inspiring, you know, or is braver than the routine. So again, with Qaide Azam Zindabad, Fahad's acting skills will give a lot of life to the character, I think. Fatman's cast will reveal very soon, inshallah. Fatman is a social drama. It is a family social drama where we've talked about a very, very painful problem in the society, which is body shaming. And it's not at all lecturesome, you know. It is in a very normal way we've talked about a character who's part of this society but treated differently just because he's a certain body type. And it's gonna be all in a very, very light way. And again, the film then gets into a vigilante superhero phase, which is why it's called Fatman, you know. So it's gonna be a first superhero vigilante kind of a film that comes from Pakistan.